when they were building the Mpiji, Kanoni, Sembabule, Masaka Road, they passed through my land. They took 21 acres, not 1 acre like the other village was demanding. They took 21 acres. I was very happy because I'm the one who needs that road. The road is not needed by the head of the civil service here because he doesn't go to our area. It is me who needs the road. So I am the one who has been, you come, build the road, and when you are ready, you can compensate me. And how much did they compensate me for my 21 acres? 79 million shillings. Now, this villager in Kamwenge was demanding, I think 3 billion or something like that. Imagine for 1 acre. I think even half an acre, it's not correct. This must be resolved. We are not. Bale kangaliwa sande kola. Niboko liweta sande kola. Namaz matigari mubo. Our economy has been built mainly on natural resources, agriculture, some small extent minerals, tourism. But now, because of our educated human resource, we are going to have a significant portion of the economy built on human intellect and skills. Amagezi, na wobugaga, simwanyizoka. When somebody builds a car, that is now not coffee, but it is a new form of wealth from the brain and from the skills of the hand. Now, since we have got our big number of educated people, I have already written to the government, I don't want to hear of imported buses. The buses will be built here. I also don't want to hear of assembled buses, no? Because assembled means somebody makes the bus outside and you come and you assemble it for him here. What I want to hear of is bus fabrications here. There will be no assembling, there will be no importing, we shall make the buses ourselves, and we have the capacity. And the pickups and the lorries and the Chira electric car, we are moving. And all this, all other types of vehicles. Under the Chira Motor Corporation project, 2 electric buses have so far been developed, and the construction of the vehicle assembly plant in Jinja, assembling our own, not assembling other people's parts. This is expected to be completed by June 2021. A country like Japan has no coffee, has no oil. They don't even have agriculture. They depend on the human intellect to build all these cars which you are all driving. Toyota, what? That's their wealth. For us, we are lucky. We can have both the natural resources, wealth, but also this wealth of the brain and the hand and the skills. This year's school education calendar has been disrupted by COVID-19. However, new methods of learning are being tested to ensure that our children continue to learn. To improve learning in UPE schools, government will strengthen the supervision and ensure accountability for school outcomes. As regards health, government will increase focus on proper nutrition, especially in the areas of childhood development. In addition to improving further the health infrastructure and assuring provision of medicines in health facilities across the country. The Minister of Health has been delaying one of our scientists. I hope he's on the radio so that he doesn't give up. There's a scientist who discovered a computer system which can trace the drug, the medicines, from the factory to the national medical stores, to the health center, up to the patient. But the Minister of Health have been delayed to. So, Dr. Chiyimba, when you are there, know that I've not forgotten. Dr. Chiyimba, I hope you are listening. It will stop this theft of drugs. Uganda's economic outlook, as I said, is positive. COVID-19 pandemic has helped us to once again demonstrate the economic capacity and opportunity that our country has. The measures undertaken to prevent the further spread of the disease have helped those who could not see the opportunity and comparative advantages of Uganda to now see them clearly, especially in the areas of local production, import replacement to enable us to use our foreign currency for more strategic issues, and increase exports and creation of jobs. On the side of import substitution, I recently guided the country that in order for us to build a stronger and more resilient economy, we must address 8 or 9 fundamental human needs. Those are food, clothes, shelter, defense, human resource development, which is education and health, and infrastructure, electricity, roads, the railway, ICT, telecommunications. And the 9th was the spiritual needs of the human being. With these in place, other subsectors will emerge, and these include tourism, hospitality, hotels, bars, nightclubs, as well as entertainment, concerts, sports. The COVID-19 pandemic, therefore, provides great opportunities for us to accelerate our import substitution and export promotion drive in the context of enhanced investments in the 9. In the nine crucial areas.